Hey, welcome to Business Made Simple. It's the daily video designed to either make you money, save you money, or somehow advance your career. And today I want to talk about the idea that making money is actually costing you money. It's the biggest concept that I can explain to anybody in business. Some of you, it's going to feel really rudimentary, but it isn't. It's something you even need to be reminded about, and it's this. It's called opportunity cost, and you want your entire team, everybody on your team, to understand the idea of opportunity cost. Opportunity cost happens when you ask yourself, how much money am I losing by not taking a better opportunity? Here's how I learned about opportunity cost. It was many years ago. I was a best-selling author and a speaker, and I was accepting speaking gigs for $5,000. And at the time, that was great. I mean, that paid my mortgage for a few months, and $5,000 is nothing you passed up. And I had a manager who was taking those gigs and getting me on the road, and it was really great. Well, as the books began to sell more and more of those opportunities came up. And I was making great money. I was traveling the country for $5,000 a pop. And pretty soon I realized I'm not writing any books right now. I'm not writing any books because I fly back to Portland, Oregon. I'm exhausted. That's where I lived at the time. And I don't have the energy to sit down and write. It takes me 2 days to recover. And then I sit down, I get back into the book. It takes me a day to get back into the book. By the fourth day, I'm finally writing on the book, and I'm on a plane the next day to another speaking gig. So what I figured out was, you know, the $5,000 is costing me $500,000 if I can write another best-selling book. And so you kind of do the math there, and you realize it sounds crazy, but I would make more money by staying home. And pretty soon, I had to adjust my whole management system because people kept sending me out to make $5,000 and I couldn't stay home to make 50 or 500. And so I began to up my fee. You know, I'll only come out for 15 and now it's much higher than that. And pretty soon you realize opportunity cost, by not calculating opportunity costs, you're going to be a wealthy man, but you're never going to be a super, super rich man or woman because you are not putting money into what you could be doing in the future. Everybody on your staff needs to understand opportunity costs. It isn't just that analogy. It's things like, I remember I had a staff member come to us recently and say, not recently, a few years ago, and say, we should start a coaching program. We should have coaches on staff that coach people. We can charge them $800 a month. And we sat down with a pencil, and $800 a month is great revenue. And if that coach could have 10 people, at the same time, we now have 20 more people on staff, two people managing them, this health insurance, this cost, we have staff turnover, and then that's going to take away our bandwidth to be able to do more creative things by managing a coaching team. We said the opportunity cost on this is way too high. So what happens is we see a $10,000 opportunity and we go chase it. We don't calculate the opportunity cost of having to take energy from somewhere else, and we end up just capping the size of our company. So all of your people need to understand the concept of opportunity cost. And when you are about to make a decision, you as the leader need to turn around and say, hey, give me the opportunity cost on this. If we do this, what are we missing out on? What revenue are we missing out on because we went and chased this revenue? Also, what overhead are we increasing because we have made this decision? Those are the two sides of the equation that go into my decision making. But opportunity cost is just enormous. And when you begin to calculate it, you'll still make bad decisions sometimes, but those bad decisions at least will have a red light on the dashboard. And you can say, nah, opportunity cost is too high on this. Today's simple tip, always calculate the opportunity cost. And a real simple tip is this, always ask people when you're making decisions, what is the opportunity cost on that? Get the phrase opportunity cost, get that into your vocabulary at the office, and you will end up making a lot more money and saving a lot more money. You will end up not taking good opportunities because taking good opportunities is costing you great opportunities. That's today's simple tip.